Good evening, everybody. This is Pastor Jon Albrecht from Living Faith Fellowship Church in Superior, Nebraska. Thank you for joining us again on Facebook Live for our Wednesday evening service. And we're just so thankful that you're joining us today. And God is a good God. Amen. He does good things for us every day. Usually during this time, we have praise reports, something good God's done for us. So think of something that God did for you today and start thanking Him for that. I used Zoom for the first time when we had a meeting today, and I was just really proud, I guess, in that way, because God helped me to click on the right buttons and get onto Zoom, and it worked. So I was like, technology, hey, praise God, it does work. So thank God for all the little things, and we're learning a lot more about technology right now, aren't we? But thank God that we can be together tonight. There's no distance in the spirit, and we're just thankful. We had a powerful time of prayer just a few minutes ago, and we're going to have some more prayer at the end. We're praying for the nation, and I also got a message for you from the Lord tonight, too. So let's pray, and then we're going to join into some praise and worship. Let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for the power of God.
Yes.
We thank you for the power of God
yes.
in our lives. Thank you for what you're doing, Lord,
yes.
each and every day,
Jesus.
That you are working and moving and living in us
yes.
today, right now. And the greater one, greater is he that lives in you than he that is in the world. You got the greater one on the inside of you. And we thank you, Lord, for the greater one moving and living in us. And we thank you for the precious blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over each one of us. The blood of Jesus repels the coronavirus. Nothing, no plague can come nigh our dwelling, near wherever we're at. We thank you for it, Father, for the divine protection. And we thank you for this time tonight. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are welcome here. You are welcome here in our service. And we thank you for the moving of the Holy Spirit. We thank you for what you want to be said and done. And we just receive all that you have for us tonight. And we thank you for the anointing that destroys the yoke of bondage. And we thank you and we receive it tonight. And we thank you and we give you the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Glory of God, the nations to increase.
Tonight. Thank you, Lord, for all that you're doing for us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for touching each person right now with your healing power. Thank you with your divine health and protection. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. And that first song that we sang was so appropriate because we prayed before about dispelling and breaking the powers of darkness. And Father, in the name of Jesus, if there's anybody watching by Facebook, you need that same anointing that's here. I can sense that anointing. That anointing is going out to you right now. Breaking that darkness, dispelling that darkness and gloom. Darkness and gloom, you're gone in Jesus' name. You cannot stay. The sun, the S-O-N, is shining bright. The S-O-N is shining bright in Jesus' name. The light of the sun, the light of the sun is shining in your life tonight. The light of the sun is shining through the darkness. The darkness is gone in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father God. We live in the light. We're children of the light. Yes, the light of Jesus. The light of the world is Jesus Christ. And we are the light of the world because we have his light shining bright on the inside of us. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Your light is shining brighter than ever before right now. In Jesus' name, thank you, Father God. Anxiety has to leave. Worry has to leave. Fear has to leave. Depression has to leave in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In there's any ailment whatsoever, you tell it to go in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Tendonitis, you have to leave in the name of Jesus. I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Whatever you have that the devil says you have, but you don't have it, say, you have to leave in Jesus' name. You have to leave. You cannot stay on my body in Jesus' name. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. We thank you for it in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. God is so good. Hallelujah. God is so good. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. We just thank you for joining us tonight. And we're going to have a powerful message from the Lord tonight. We just thank you. And I know the power of God is here. And anything that you need tonight, just receive it now in the presence of the Lord. And you may be seated and we'll get ready for our lesson. Several different things to read you tonight. This is a letter by Randy Greer, and people in our church know who Randy Greer is. Randy Greer was in prison for 10 years, and he was supposed to be paroled in the month of none, N-O-N-E, none, and he is a powerful minister of God, and he is a Rhema graduate, and Pastor Patsy, this was the first church he ever preached at when he was still going to school. She met him down in Tulsa when he was a usher. And he wrote this powerful article, and I want to read this to you tonight because it's very powerful. It's called The Coronavirus in the Church. Greetings in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm blessed to know that you are a faith person that believes God when you fall into different tests and trials. James chapter 1 tells us to count it all joy when we fall into different tests and trials. We are believing with you and praying for you that you stand fast in the word and spirit during this time. It seems that most of the world and many in the body of Christ are in a time of fear and panic. Jesus taught us all to fear, not because he is with us always. Or Jesus taught us all to fear not because he is with us always. I realize that this panic and fear in the church comes from a conspiracy theory that a secret society founded in the 1800s is trying to take over the world and vaccinate us with the Antichrist chip. And that some of those teachings go around, they say. There is also the idea that our United States government is trying to shut down churches and close their doors. The minister who proposes these theories has written two books on conspiracies to take over the world and our government, and is in the process of writing a third book this year. These books do not preach the gospel, but only espouse conspiracy theories. This makes us aware that this individual's mind is saturated with this type of thinking, not the word of God. Get the books for yourself and you will see. I have personally purchased these books and reviewed them myself. That is why it has taken me this long to comment about it. The Bible says that only a fool answers a matter before he hears it. Jesus did not preach conspiracy theories about the Roman Empire when the Jews were in captivity to them in his day. He also told his disciples to go and preach the gospel of the kingdom, not conspiracy theories. Jesus was led as a lamb to the slaughter with no protest and hung on the cross for us all. He set an example for us, so keep preaching the gospel of the kingdom and not conspiracy theories. Because of the conspiracy theory, the United States is trying to shut down churches. Some have elected to disobey health authorities by not limiting large gatherings and spreading the coronavirus. I am not afraid of the coronavirus, and it will not come near me, my family, or my dwelling. You should believe the same thing. However, all men have not the same faith you do. Using wisdom during this time is not disobedient to God or his word. The government is not going to stop us from preaching the gospel. If they attempt it, I will lead the march to the White House myself and make them shut my mouth. I ain't scared of the government or anyone else. I spent 10 years of my life in prison, and I'm not scared of going back for the gospel or the Lord Jesus Christ. Like I have said before and say it again by the Spirit of God, the things that are going on today are a natural and spiritual correction that I have spoken about many times in the last 10 years or so. Many in the church think that they are fighting the government when they really are fighting God. Things are out of God's divine order in the world and in the church. He permitted this to happen to get the world's attention and to get the church's attention. A good example is when Jesus Christ walked into Dad Hagen's hospital room when he had chipped his elbow. That's Kenneth E. Hagen he's talking about. Jesus emphatically told him, "I did not do this. The devil did, but I permitted it." You may say, "If I knew this was going to happen, why didn't I stop it?" You may want to get angry with me for not stopping it, but you should thank me. For had I not permitted this to happen to get your attention, you would not have lived past the age of 55 years old. You would have died. He didn't start Raymond until he was 57, so Raymond would never have existed. This is the third time that I have had to speak to you about this, and that is why I allowed it to happen. Whether you believe it or not, when you get to heaven, you will find out that what I am telling you is the truth. This correction and shaking going on in the world and the church has been permitted by God. There's a correction and a shaking going on in the natural world right now, and some will not survive. Quickly on the heels of this, there will come a correction and shaking in the church world, which is already occurring. Only those founded upon the rock, Jesus Christ, and the Word of God will stand. Immerse yourself in the Word and prayer and help others in this time of need. Instead of fighting the government, reach out to those who are sick, poor, and in financial need, and lead them to Christ. Many will turn to Jesus during this time if they have the right voice to lead them to the cross. If you are not scared of the virus, go to their house and raise them up, and their whole family will turn to God, especially if they are dying. We can make this the church's brightest hour or darkest hour. It's up to us. Preaching conspiracy never saved a soul. Preach Jesus, and God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. I command you for standing strong and true during this time and remembering from where you come. I believe this will be the church's finest hour, regardless of the conflict, virus, conspiracies, and financial need. God is with us and we cannot fail. Randy Greer. Praise God. He's bold. He's very bold. But thank you, Jesus. He tells it like it is. Amen. And just search it for yourself if you don't believe that. But God, you'll find out. So praise God, we stand firm, we stand true. And we're gonna just continue to walk each day. And it's made me realize, I was telling someone today, I said, my new normal is that nothing is normal. That's my new normal right now, is that there's nothing in my life that is normal. And you know, I'm a person who doesn't like a lot of change. I like the old stuff. Ask people who know me well, I like old music. I love Southern Gospel. I like old programs. I like antiques. I like things that have been the same for a long time. And I don't like a whole lot of change. But you know, things have been changing a lot lately. But you know, God, Christ, the solid rock, Jesus, he's the anchor for our soul.
Amen.
And so we stay firmly anchored in him. Amen. And we watch him, we look unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, and we stay hooked to him. And we won't get pushed around or the waves. Yes. When we're anchored down, we're not going to be floating around in places where we shouldn't be. Amen. So last Sunday, we talked about this blood's for you. And if you didn't see it, you can go back in our Facebook archive and you can see that from March 29th. We talked about redemption through the blood of Jesus, fellowship with God through the blood of Jesus, and healing through the blood of Jesus. Tonight we're going to talk about part two tonight. We're going to talk about protection through the blood of Jesus and authority over the devil through the blood of Jesus. But I want to read a scripture to you, and if you ever went to Rhema, you would know this scripture, or if you know Kenneth E. Hagin, you would know this scripture, because this is what we call his trademark scripture, Mark 11:23, and the New King James says, "For surely I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, 'Be removed and be cast into the sea,' and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says." And so we need to realize that you get what you say.
Amen.
We live in a rural community. I'm a farm boy. I grew up as a farm boy, okay? So I understand farming terms. Well, let me give you two examples of this. Whatever you sow, that shall you also reap. And whatever you speak, every time you speak, it's like sowing seed, and you're going to reap a harvest.
That's right.
And so I like to garden. I may not consider myself that great of a gardener, but I do know if I plant tomato plants, I'm going to get tomatoes, not eggplant. If I plant cucumbers, I'm going to get cucumbers, not corn. Okay? I know the difference. And some vegetables I may not know the difference of. But if you want something, you got to plant it. Well, if you want something, then you plant positive things. But if you want something negative, then if you allow your mouth to speak negative, 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 then that's what negative will come back. And something about, how about weeds? I would talk about this every year, but the more I garden, you don't have to plant weeds. You don't have to cultivate them. You don't have to water them. They will grow. And I tell you, for some reason, they're growing this year really well. And I've already had to get them in the cracks of my sidewalk and all over the place. I'm pulling weeds. I'm digging weeds out. That's like your negative words. Are like weeds that will grow and that will take over your life if you allow it to, and your life will become very negative. You know, weeds will take over. If you nip them in the bud when they're little, they're really easy to take care of. But if you let them get big, like big fire, we call them fire weeds, tumbleweeds, because they're allowed to grow. Don't allow those negative thoughts to come out of your mouth and you speak them into existence. You say no. In the name of Jesus, you take authority over that, and you won't allow negative thoughts to come out of your mouth. Because what you say is what you get. Another good illustration that Reverend Charles Capps is very famous for, if you want the dog, don't call the cat. Now, I can remember my mother on the farm, and we had cats that lived in the barn, and they were all across the yard. I mean, that's quite a ways away. If she wanted the cats to come and she put some food out there and sometimes some milk, she'd yell, kitty, 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 and it was really loud, high-pitched loud. Those cats knew her voice. They came running from the barn and they come and get that food. She didn't yell for the dog. She yelled for the cats. So if you want healing, don't speak about how sick you are.
That's right.
If you want to be financially blessed, don't talk about how poor you are. If you want joy, then don't talk about how sad you are. Because you're calling for the dog and you're getting the kitty. Yeah. You want the kitty and you're calling for the dog. You know, you're doing the opposite of what you need. So use positive words. Use the word of God. And here's some scriptures for you. And the Lord really put this on my heart today as we had prayer this morning. Psalm 60, verse 12. Psalm 60, verse 12. Through God we will do valiantly. For it is he who shall tread down our enemies. So God, he's already treaded down our enemies. He will trample or tread them down. Amen? Coronavirus. He's already tread down coronavirus. Psalm 91, verse 13. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra. The young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. So trample that virus. Trample it. Say, in the name of Jesus, you're under my feet. That's what we did this morning. You're under my feet, coronavirus. You're under my feet, sickness. You're under my feet, anxiety. You're under my feet, depression. Whatever it is, you're under my feet. And sometimes it just helps you to do that. Amen. You know, there's a song, the devil's under my feet. Now my victory is complete. Jesus, now I don't have all the words, but Jesus spoiled principalities, made a show of them ultimately. He's under my feet. The devil's under my feet. Jesus' name is above. But the devil's under my feet. Amen? Praise God. Luke 10:19. Behold, I give to you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Right.
So I'm giving you these scriptures as your arsenal here to have. Behold, I give you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall harm you, shall hurt you. Amen? And Psalm 103, verse 3. Who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases. Who heals all your diseases. And that includes the coronavirus. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. So speak those words out. Speak those positive words out. You know, it just makes you feel better when you do it. Praise God.
Yes.
It gets into your spirit. Get that word of God into your spirit. If you've got extra time, then spend more time in the word. Spend more time in prayer. Spend your time with these things. Instead of Lion King, I didn't even know what that was. I think that's not like, is it Lion something? I don't know. But I heard Dave Ramsey talk about it. People are watching it on Netflix. I don't want to watch that. I want to read the Word of God. I don't care about all those other things, okay? Tiger King, that's what it was. It was Tiger King. It wasn't Lion King. Tiger King. Whatever. I didn't even know what it was.
Trash is what it is.
It's trash, okay. James says it's trash, and I believe it. So don't watch trash. Watch, read the Word of God. And you can get the Word of God in so many kinds of forms, with dramatized, whatever it is. There's so many things. Study the Word of God. Amen? So protection. Protection through the blood of Jesus. Amen? Exodus 12:13. When I see the blood, I will pass over you.
Yes.
And, you know, the Jews celebrate Passover. That's very beautiful and very wonderful to remember the Passover. In Exodus, after 9 devastating plagues, Pharaoh still refused to let God's people go. And you can go through there and you can look through Exodus and read that about all the plagues. If you've ever watched the Ten Commandments, you know, that's still an awesome movie. You know, it's amazing the technology that they used way back when they made that movie, but it's something else. I would love that movie. It may not be 100% scriptural, but it's a good movie. But God sent a final plague, one of judgment, to smite all the firstborn in the land of Egypt. That's Exodus 12:12. And as sons of Adam, Satan knew the children of Israel had broken covenant with God, and they were due judgment. Okay? God could protect them, but not without the blood. They had a covenant relationship with God through Abraham, but they needed to stand in that covenant. They needed to choose the covenant over the curse. So each family had to have a lamb, and they had to sprinkle that, or to take that blood and over the doorposts, and put it over the doorposts, spread it over the doorposts. God instructed them to take the blood of the lamb and paint it on their doorposts. They did, and the angel of death passed by. Was it really the blood of the lamb that stopped them from being killed? No, not just the physical lamb. We're talking about the blood of the Lamb, Jesus. And that was a promise that Jesus had not come in the flesh yet. But they stood on that promise of the Lamb to come, and God passed over. And Jesus was the Lamb, and it says in Revelation 13:8, and it says, all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. He was slain from the foundation of the world. God saw this from the beginning of the world. If you look in Ephesians 1, it talks about that too, Ephesians 1:4. From the foundation of the world, the beginning of the world, he knew that there had to be a redemption for mankind, and it was Jesus Christ. Amen. The blood of the Lamb is inexhaustible and never-ending. The blood does not run out. Praise God. It's an unlimited supply. When we apply the blood of Jesus to the doorposts of our lives in faith, we have access and the power to defeat every part of the curse that tries to take residence. When you speak the name of Jesus in the face of sickness, disease, or danger, the blood of the Lamb is behind you, and you are protected. Praise God.
Amen.
You can have knowledge, or you can have a confidence that God has protected you. Amen? You are protected at all times. And then the authority over the devil through the blood of Jesus. The authority over the devil through the blood of Jesus. Revelation 12:11. And we used that last time. It's a powerful scripture. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Now your confession, as another version says, confession. So you overcome the devil by the blood of the Lamb and by your confession.
That's right.
So that's what we talk about tonight.
That's right.
You need to keep your confession. Now, does that mean we deny the facts? Well, there really is no coronavirus here. I'm free to go do whatever I want because there's no, I just thank you, it's gone, or in Jesus' name, it's gone. Is that the right way? No. You have to use wisdom.
Amen.
And as we read that letter from Randy Greer, he says you have to obey the authorities because there are people thinking that they're doing God's work and they're disobeying the authorities. And there was one gentleman who the police tried to talk to him several times, repeatedly, and he refused to talk to them. How sad. No, we are not supposed to do that. Okay? We need to use wisdom, but we also don't have to walk in fear. And we can be led by the Spirit of God. We can all be led by the Spirit of God. You can be led where to go and what not to go. You realize that? The Holy Spirit can tell you when to go to the grocery store. The Holy Spirit can tell you when to get gas. The Holy Spirit can tell you where not to go. If He says don't go somewhere, then don't go. Listen to the voice of the Spirit. I did not even plan that. That came out of my spirit to you tonight. Praise that God. You are to be led by the Spirit of God. Amen. And you can be led on your everyday duties and your everyday chores. You can be led in divine protection wherever you go. You can be open to that. Tuned in to the Holy Ghost. You know, you can have an old-fashioned radio, because a lot of these new ones are nice with the digital, but the old-fashioned ones, and I've got one, like, it loses its tuning sometimes. It's just old. I mean, I've had it for, it's my clock radio. I've had it for 30 years, probably. And so I have to just be real careful with the little dial and tune it in just right, and it will get the radio station. Otherwise, it's just a bunch of static. Well, what about your spirit? You need to tune yourself in to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit. And you know, you don't get that by watching Tiger King or whatever it is. You get it by spending time in the presence of the Lord. And like we did tonight, you get it by praying, by reading the Word, by getting in the presence of God. You hear from the voice, you hear God. You hear the voice of the Holy Ghost. And He will divinely direct you and lead you where you're supposed to go and when you're not supposed to go somewhere. Amen? Mm-hmm. Praise God. There is someone who knows, maybe even better than you, the power and authority given to you by the blood of Jesus. He will do anything to make sure you never find it out. He'll try to keep you distracted. He'll send people or ideas to confuse you and plant seeds of doubt to keep you from operating in what belongs to you. And it's not your next door neighbor either, okay? It's the devil. And he tries to come to steal, kill, and destroy, okay? John 10:10. So don't listen to him. And we don't listen to the devil. We listen to the truth of God's word. And we listen to the truth. And we come where we can hear the truth of God's word. And when you do that, you can put the devil under your feet. Amen. And that means also that he's an accuser. He's an accuser of the brethren. He says we're guilty. But we know that God is the righteous judge, and we know that God will, He calls us righteous because of the blood. The blood is our defense. 2 Corinthians 5:21, He made Him who knew no sin to be made sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in Him. We have become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So praise God, we don't have to listen to the devil or his lies. The blood is our defense. It declares that we are not guilty. We are free from the penalty of sin. The blood kicks Satan out of the affairs of our lives and the lives of our families. We do it by faith. Andrew Murray said, faith in the blood produces great results. Faith in the blood produces great results. Every day you have the right to exercise that authority by pleading what the blood of Jesus has done for you. Refuse to give the enemy even one small inch of territory. Don't give him any territory. Satan is a defeated foe. And through the precious blood of Jesus, we are victorious. Amen? And you can live that way every day. Now, do we always feel victorious? Do our emotions, and have your emotions been, I want you to realize mine are going, but you don't listen to that. You're not moved by that. You stay even keeled by hearing the word of God, and on the inside, you listen to the voice of the Spirit on the inside, even though you may be feeling like this, but you can be this because of greater is He. 1 John 4:4, greater is He that is in you than He is in the world. The greater one lives in you, and He will help you to be even healed, even when everyone else is going like this. I mean, they're ups and downs and topsy-turvy and all those things, and I'm not saying you're immune, but you never feel anything. But you don't act on it and you don't speak it out. You tell it to stop in Jesus' name. You take authority over that in the name of Jesus. Amen? And you have victory. When you receive revelation of the power of Jesus has provided for you, He's provided redemption, fellowship, healing, protection, and authority over the devil, you will begin to operate in the fullness of its power. The blood of Jesus is enough to overcome everything that comes against you. This is how we live a life of victory. and it's the life that Jesus died to give you. And remember that Jesus is Lord. He is the Lord of your life. The Bible says that every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. And so we're going to have prayer in just a few minutes, but I want those that have been watching today and those that have been listening, if there's anybody watching today and you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life, I want to show you something, and I want to show you something simple that you can use or your kids can use that will help you to talk about Jesus, okay? And I got one right here. Do I have the other thing? Yes, I do. First of all, Easter's coming up, and we had to postpone our Easter egg hunt. We will have it. After all this all these restrictions are lifted, we have 10,000 plastic eggs. But I love the resurrection eggs. And this is a dozen eggs that have symbols of Easter in it. And this one right here has a whip, a little whip. And this is a reminder. Isaiah 53:5, he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we were healed. 1 Peter 2:24, we were healed by the stripes of Jesus. So the whip reminds us of the healing power of God. So that was in the egg. I'm going to have a different egg each time that I come the next few times here, because Easter's coming up. And remember the whip that reminds you of the stripes on his back that paid for your healing. Jesus paid for your healing. Now I got the wordless book, and this has 5 pages in it. And there's nothing in it but colors. Black. Well, you can help. You can talk to somebody about that. Black reminds us of sin. Black reminds us of depression. This is what some people are going through right now. They're feeling black and gloomy and dark because they don't have hope in Jesus. But thank God for the blood. The precious blood of Jesus that cleanses us from all sin. Thank God for the blood. Thank God for the blood. The blood gives us the victory. Amen. We live in Nebraska and we say, go big red. Amen. Well, this is the big red that we need to be talking about now, is the red, the blood of Jesus that cleanses us, pray, and redeems us. And he makes us white as snow. It says in Isaiah 1, your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. And you know, I love snow. It's looking like we're not going to get any more snow this year, but I do enjoy it. But I love that Jesus cleanses us and makes us pure and white as snow. A lot of people have been using a lot of bleach lately, right? And bleach can clean a lot of stuff, but the blood of Jesus, it cleanses us better than bleach and makes us white and clean and pure before God. And then we're seeing, and I already mowed my yard, couldn't believe it. One of the earliest times I've mowed my yard. And my yard's getting green, okay? And so we do like green. I like it when the yard is green instead of brown. Don't like that. And so we are not brown. We're green. We have everlasting life in us. We will live forever in heaven. You got the life of God in you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Right now, the life of God flows through you. And then the yellow represents heaven. We have heaven and the streets of gold. And we can be with Jesus forever in heaven. We ask him to come into your heart. So if there's anybody here today and you've never done that before, if you've never asked Jesus to be the Lord of your life, you can do that today. You can pray and ask God to come in and be your Lord. So we're going to say that prayer today, and I'm going to ask those that are here in the sanctuary to repeat it after me, and you just pray with us. Amen. Believe this in your heart. Say this after me. Dear Lord,
I believe
that Jesus Christ,
died on the cross
and rose from the dead. Come into my heart, Jesus, and be my Lord and my Savior. Thank you for forgiving me and for cleansing me from all sin. Jesus, you're my Lord, my Savior, and my best friend. And I will serve you forever. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you prayed that prayer, you are now born again. Your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And you start watching our Facebook posts, and we have information. You can contact our church if you want, and we'd be glad to give you any information and let us know if we can pray for you in any way. just contact us and let us know if you did that. You can put right down in the comments that you accepted Jesus as your Savior. You can do that. But whatever you need, we're there for you. We love you very, very much. And so now we're going to go into our prayer time. And I've got some information here for you. Does everybody in the congregation have these papers? Okay. And we have what we call the daily prayer briefing. I'm going to read that, first of all. And you can become part of the presidential prayer team by going to their website, and you can get these presidential, these daily prayer briefings every day. Today, President Donald Trump will take part in a call with military families regarding the U.S. response to the COVID-19 outbreak. The president has called upon the U.S. Armed Forces to combat an unseen threat in the form of this pandemic, and today he will discuss what the federal government can do amid or to aid and protect America's soldiers. Last week, Secretary of Defense Mark Esper said that due to the nature of the work ahead, military personnel and their families are expected to be on the front lines of the outbreak. While there is a global halt in station moves for individuals, he added that social distancing would be difficult as personnel have no choice but to work and live closely with one another. He added that it would be very difficult for many in the armed forces to remain 6 feet apart. As part of the extended impact, the stimulus bill signed by the president includes additional funding for the medical care of veterans and their families. At the end of last week, the president signed an executive order allowing military branches to recall reserve members as necessary. Ahead of the order, thousands of retired Army personnel responded to a voluntary recall request from the U.S. Army to join the fight against the virus. During the request, the Army asked for those with experience as a critical care officer, anesthesiologist, nurse anesthetist, critical care nurse, nurse practitioner, ER nurse, respiratory specialist, or medic. As the Lord leads, pray with us, and we'll pray together here. Father, we pray for the president as he meets with military families, and we thank you, Lord, as he continues to meet with military families, and he has divine wisdom to take care of them. We thank you for encouragement, strength, and protection for the thousands of members of the armed forces who are putting themselves at risk to combat the virus outbreak. We plead the blood of Jesus over them. Yes. And we claim Psalm 91 that they are divinely protected. Father, we thank you. They will not come near them. We thank you that they are protected in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Lord, to bring about a swift end to the virus. And we thank you for that. And your name is glorified above all. And we thank you that this has been broken already. And we thank you for it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Amen. And then we have a sheet which Don Wiest has made for us. And this is from Psalm 91, 5 through 7, and then 10 through 11 in the New Living Translation. And we're going to pray this. Those in the sanctuary can pray together with me. Our President, Donald Trump, is not afraid of the terrors of the night, nor the arrow that flies in the day. He does not dread the disease, COVID-19, that stalks in darkness, nor the disaster that strikes at midday. Though thousands fall on our sides, though 10,000 are dying around us, these evils will not touch us. Since we have made the Lord our refuge and we make the Most High our shelter, no evil will conquer us in the United States, no plague will come near our homes. The Lord will order his angels to protect us wherever we go. And we'll make this declaration. Lord, thank you that you are my source of peace. Even in troubled times, I will rest in your love for me and your great faithfulness. Thank you that your name is above every name. I will not fear. I will trust in you. In Jesus' name, amen. And then here's some presidential prayer requests, and I'll just pray this, and you agree with me. Father, we pray for God to bring healing to those who are sick, and that he would preserve the health of those who have not contracted the virus, that the country will be able to be opened up for business with the coming weeks, for GM to quickly create the needed supplies to end the spread of the disease, for groups like Samaritan's Purse who have added their contribution to that of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers and others in giving help to New York City, for donors and nurses being recruited from across the country, including out of retirement, to work the coronavirus pandemic, for researchers and laboratories around the world seeking the best solutions with therapeutic drugs and vaccines against future outbreaks, for members of Congress setting aside divisive ideological goals or pet projects, and the president to work together in a rapid bipartisan manner to to give more stimulus to the national economy. For Americans to take heart, Mike Lindell's message of daily, of praying daily, spending time in God's Word, and enjoying life with their families. And other leaders, we lift up the Office of Trade and Manufacturing Policy Director Peter Navarro, U.S. Senator from North Dakota Kevin Kramer, D.C. Circuit U.S. Court of Appeals Judge Thomas Griffith, National Guard Bureau Chief General Joseph L. Lengel. Thank you, Father. We just lift these up to you tonight in the name of Jesus. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. And we're going to have Kathy come up, and we're going to pray for a few minutes. Now, we are a Spirit-filled Pentecostal church, and we believe in praying in the Word of God. We believe in praying in English, and we also believe in praying in other tongues. And we know that as we pray tonight, that you're going to sense the presence of God when we pray. So if you're not familiar with what we're doing, we're praying in other tongues. And we have, God has given us a personal prayer language that we can pray and we can intercede and know the divine, perfect will of God. So for the next few minutes, we're going to be praying. And then I may be praying in English at times too. But we're going to be praying for our country, for all these situations. And you can join us in prayer at this time. Father God, we just thank you for the privilege of coming to you tonight in prayer. And thank you, Lord, that you have broken the powers of darkness. You've broken through the clouds of despair. And that just comes to me tonight. The sunlight, the S-O-N, is shining through. We thank you for that, Father God. And we thank you that you are shining through the entire United States of America. It's as if there was a dark cloud over this country, but it's breaking through as the sun starts to break through. That's what's happening right now in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, that the sun, the light of the Lord Jesus Christ, is breaking through. And you carry light wherever you go, those that are listening today. And we thank you, Lord, that you help us to carry those lights, and that we will shine bright wherever we're at, Father God. We lift up President Trump to you tonight. We lift up his whole family. We thank you for divine protection over him. We plead the blood of Jesus. We claim Psalm 91. We lift up Vice President Pence and his family. We plead the blood of Jesus and claim Psalm 91 over all their staff, over all of Congress, over everyone on the coronavirus committee that's working on the task force. Father, we thank you for divine wisdom to them, anointing them. We lift up all the military as we have prayed, Father God, divine wisdom in all they do and everywhere that they go, Father. And we lift up our country tonight. And as we pray in the Spirit, we thank you for your divine inspiration tonight as we pray in the Spirit. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, la ma kare, la ma sika la no. Oh, la ma sika la ma. Oh, la ma ha. The veil of darkness has been broken through. The veil of darkness has been broken through. In Jesus' name. Oh, la ma shaka ha le gose. We break the spirit of suicide over that person or persons in the name of Jesus. We break that spirit of suicide in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. It's broken in the name of Jesus. And they will know their love with an everlasting love. Thank you, Father God. Bring forth laborers across their path. Touch them with your love, Father. Touch them with people to show them how much they are loved. We thank you for it right now in the name of Jesus. That is broken. No, 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 says the Lord. No, 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 says the Lord. You are loved. I love you with an everlasting love. You are loved more than you can ever know. That's what the Lord says to you tonight, my brother or my sister. I thank you for it right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Touch those. Touch those. Touch those. Thank you. Thank you, Father, right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lord, I pray for that person that's been under condemnation. Whatever it was that they did, Father God, they're very ashamed of what they did. Well, Father, I thank you that the blood of Jesus cleanses them. The blood of Jesus cleanses them. You don't have to no longer be ashamed. Jesus has forgiven you. God has forgiven you. You are cleansed from all unrighteousness. You are loved with an everlasting love. We break the power of the enemy over your life. In the name of Jesus, that's broken. In Jesus' name. And the freedom, enlighten the eyes of understanding right now. To see and to know and experience your love right now, Father God. And your forgiveness and your hope that's in their life. They will not look to the past. They will not look to the past. So they'll look forward. Keep their eyes on Jesus. Thank you, Father God. And they'll keep their eyes on you. Keep our eyes on Jesus, the author and the finisher of their faith. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Lila Masula Makadi Mashukola Mati, Lila Masukola Mahashika Mogit, Dora Maksakara de Bahoshika, Nod and Masakama de Bahoshi, all in Mastika de Bahoshi. Oh, we just thank you, Father. We thank you for answered prayer. We just give you the glory and honor and praise tonight. We thank you for all that you have done tonight. We thank you for answered prayer, Father. We thank you and we praise you for the victory that we have through our Lord Jesus Christ. We just thank you and we praise you. And what we do on our nights that we have prayer for the nation, we always end with God Bless America. So I bet you know that song, and we're going to sing that together. Now you're watching by Facebook, there's a little bit of a lag time. You can go ahead and put something down and we'll write that down and we'll be praying for you, okay? Thank you, Jesus. We've got some requests here. Is anybody in the congregation? Yes, Ken.
Quick healing for Grandma. She's going to the nursing home tomorrow, and I just pray that she gets back on her feet and she just, you know, keeps on rocking.
All right.
She's only going for a couple weeks.
Okay.
Not permanently.
Well, I'm glad.
Yep.
It's going to help her. Anybody else? Tom.
I texted Lisa Schaefer to see if she was watching a little while ago.
Mm-hmm.
She said she spent all afternoon in her car in the hospital parking lot.
Yeah.
A tree fell on her son.
Oh.
His name is Matthew Schaefer.
Oh. Matthew Schaefer.
She said he's 27.
Broke his shoulder. So I just prayed for recovery.
So far, we haven't got any more yet here. Anybody else? Okay. Well, we'll go ahead and pray. If we see anything more, we'll pray for those too. Father, we just come to you in the name of Jesus, according to Matthew 18:19, the prayer of agreement. And we're just thanking you, Father. We're thanking you for Sue Dedlow. We thank you for that she will recover.
Yes.
She had a fall, and she will recover completely.
Yes.
And with
yes.
No problems, no anything lasting pain or anything, Father, it's gone. She no hurt to her in any way. And we just thank you that she is protected at all times. And we just plead the blood and we claim Psalm 91 over her.
Yes.
And it will not happen a second time, Father God. She'll not fall anymore. You make her feet like hind's feet, and she is taken care of. And all those that were affected by the earthquake in Boise, we thank you for touching them.
Yes.
That they're healed and whole, and their homes are repaired quickly. We just thank you for your hand upon them. In Jesus' name, we lift up Devin Tyler, that he is healed and whole from the top of his head to the soles
yes.
of his feet. We thank you for Jane Jorgensen. We thank you for your divine protection, your divine wisdom. We just thank you for the divine health of God flowing through him. In Jesus' name, Father, we lift up Mary Harden. And we just thank you, Father God. Touch her, Father God, with peace and comfort. And Father, that she will want to eat, and she will want to take her meds, and she will want to continue to get stronger, Father God. Just touch her and give her a supernatural grace to get through this time that she's in a care home and separated from her family. But Father, touch her right now. Touch her family, my brother-in-law and family. Touch them, Father God, with your peace, your comfort, your grace, your help right now. And there's no distance in the spirit. And I just pray, as I have felt prayers and many times in my life, that Mary would feel those prayers in the name of Jesus. She would feel that love, that wonderful, tangible love that you have for her. She's your daughter. She knows you, Lord. And I thank you that she will sense that and feel that tonight in Jesus' name. Give her a peace that passes all understanding. And Father, I lift up the Good Samaritan staff. I lift up all of those health workers in Superior, at the hospital, at the assisted livings, and all around our area and all around the country, Father God. We lift up these heroes, these men and women who are heroes and heroines, Father God. We thank you for touching them. We thank you for the protection of God. We plead the blood over them. We claim Psalm 91, and we thank you for the strength of God. Yes. We thank you for the grace of God, that they will continue to go forth and do their jobs. And you anoint them, Lord. You give them strength, supernatural strength, and they have such a love for those that they're taking care of. And just thank you, Lord, that you will help them and guide them and lead them and continue to protect them and their families, Father. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father God. We thank you for Shirley Crane. We thank you, Lord, that for a quick healing, any injuries have to leave. She's healed and whole, and you're not giving her a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. We thank you for it, and she will just well at the Good Samaritan Center. We thank you, Father, that she's protected too, and Father, just touch her, and thank you that she senses your love and your presence. Just take care of her. Hold her in your arms, Jesus. We thank you for that. And Father, we lift up Matthew Schaefer. We thank you for touching him. We thank you for healing that shoulder in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, that pain and discomfort have to leave his body. We thank you that he is divinely protected. We thank you for touching him right now in the name of Jesus. A quick healing, a quick recovery, and he'll be able to use that shoulder, Father God. Shoulder pain is gone in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father God. He's able to use that arm. We thank you for it, and we give you the glory, honor, and praise for what you're doing. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We lift up Evan Jacobitz with a sprained knee, Father God. Touch him right now in Jesus' name. We speak to that knee, and we call you healed and whole. He's able to walk. He's able to move. He's able to bend. He's able to do whatever he needs to do. We thank you, Father, for touching him with your healing power. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Praise the Lord. Anybody else? Did I miss anybody? Well, praise God. During this time of the service, we're going to ask if you'd like to give. And those in the sanctuary here, you can get an envelope in the chair in front of you. Make your checks out to Living Faith Fellowship Church, LFC. And those that are watching, you can give online. There's PayPal, and it's on our website. It's also on our Facebook. There's a link to that, and you can give if you want to designate your offering. Then you need to just mail it in to us and work however you want to do it. But just remember to be faithful, because the devourer is rebuked for your sake.
That's right.
And just because you might not physically be able to come to church,
yes.
I'm not saying because I want your tithe, but I want you to be protected. And I want you to continue to be faithful.
Sure.
And God will bless you. Amen. This is, you know, the Lord told me, he said, this is the time to get through this is by giving more. Mm-hmm. Not by giving less and by hoarding or taking or holding it to yourself. The time is by giving more. And then that, you watch God bless you. You watch God take care of you. You watch God provide for you. And he will do that. Amen. He's going to meet your needs. He's going to meet Living Faith Fellowship Church's needs. He's got it taken care of. It's a done deal. Don't have to worry about it. Don't have to fret. God's taking care of it. Amen. It's done, and we thank the Lord for it. And we thank the Lord for the privilege of being able to give. So we're just going to lift our envelopes to the Lord tonight, and we're going to pray. Father, we thank you for the privilege of being able to pray. And we thank you, Lord, for each person that's giving tonight, each person that's giving that's at home tonight, Father God. Just bless them. Thank you for our harvest. We claim that, and we thank you for it as we're sowing seed. And we thank you for Living Faith Fellowship Church. Every need is met. Every bill is paid. For each person here tonight that's giving, every need is met. Every bill is paid. We call it done, and we thank you for it, and we thank you for touching each person, and we give you the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Let's say our confession together, and I'll say it, and you repeat it, so those at home, if they don't have it, they can repeat it with us. As I tithe and give offerings, I'm believing you, Lord. For jobs and better jobs. Raises and bonuses. Benefits and promotions. Sales and commissions. Estates and inheritances. Interest and income. Rebates and returns. Discounts and dividends. Checks in the mail. Gifts and surprises. Bills decreased. Bills paid off. Blessings and increase. And greater victories. In the midst of greater odds. Thank you, Lord, for meeting all my needs, that I may have more than enough to give to promote the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. And receive the offering. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Well, we're glad that you joined us again for Facebook Live tonight. And we will have a service this Sunday, April 6th. It's Palm Sunday. And so please join us at 10:30 a.m. for our service, our Palm Sunday service. We're going to have some palm branches. We're going to have some decorations for Easter here. It's going to look Easter-ish, if that's a term, I don't know. But I love Easter, and maybe we're not able to do all the activities right now that we normally do, but let your heart start just preparing your heart for Easter and thinking and meditating what Jesus did for you, how he made all the difference in your life. What has Jesus done for you? And Jesus went to the cross. And meditate on some of the things that he did, how much he loves us. And share that message with others around. Ask the Holy Spirit who you can talk to, who you can pray for. And you know, there's a lot of people that will take your prayers right now. So just be open to that and hear that. And God bless you. We love you. We'll see you Sunday.